Hey, this is Joe from Presonus. In this video, I want to show you a cool little automation thing. And I got the idea from Gregor. When he listened to this mix, he said, hey, it'd be cool if you did this. I'm going to show you what the this is that he showed me, and then I'm totally taking credit for it. I remembered this as I was doing my Sphere exclusive video for Presonus Sphere members. If you've been thinking about joining Sphere, aside from getting Studio One and Notion and a bunch of add-ons, plugins and such in your account, you also get access to monthly training videos from myself and Gregor and others. So if that sounds like fun to you, you'll become a Sphere member and you will love it. Anyway, so Gregor listened to this mix and I asked him for feedback. So he listened to it and he said, this section right at bar 40 would be cool if I did this one thing to make it a little bit bigger. So let me play it for you first without the thing, and then you can listen to it and I'll explain what we're going to do. So it's a downbeat of the first chorus of the song. And what Gregor said is, I don't have the email in front of me, but he said, hey, it'd be cool if you threw the passive EQ on your mix bus, okay, and then automated a low boost to come up at that downbeat, just to emphasize that kind of transition, make it go whoom just a little bit more than the tracks allow. It's not the kind of thing you want to boost overall for the entire mix. It's really just in that spot could use a little more juice. And I thought, what the heck, why not? Let's try it. So the way I set it up, if we open up the mixer, if we look at our main output here, our master fader, if you will, this was the normal processing I had on my mix. I love this Brit comp. It's like my bus compressor. I added a second fat channel with just this EQ on it. By the way, you can use this tip whether you're a Sphere member or not. If you have Studio One, then the three stock fat channel EQs you get are standard, passive, and vintage. I'm using passive for this one. It does some really cool stuff in the really low end. And this is set to 30 hertz, which seems ridiculously low, but it adds this feel, this kind of low end bigness to the track. Here, let me just hit play and I'll just crank this so you can hear what I'm talking about. It's almost a boost that instead of hearing it, you feel it. Does that make sense? Of course it does. So to follow Gregor's suggestion, I right-clicked on this and chose Edit Automation, and it created this automation lane here in my arranger. You can see this is the low boost for this particular plugin. And then all I did was I left it at zero, and then I just automated it to go up. Let me turn automation back on. Automated it to go up from zero to what? 0.5. So just a small, I was kind of a chicken with the automation point. And it worked. It was just the subtlest of little whoo, additions to the downbeat, and I added it at the end of the chorus as well. But for the sake of just the video, just to give you an exaggerated example of what this can do, and maybe you can add this to your arsenal if you have certain sections that just need a little extra love, both bottom end and top end can be cool to implement this. Maybe boost the highs in the chorus and bring it back down, things like that. But here's what an exaggerated version of that sounds like. And because it's only affecting those really, really low frequencies, we don't get it even at that insane. I mean, we can go all the way up here. It doesn't just go nuts with our mix. Part of that is because I don't have a lot of extra low end in my mix to mess with, because I've done some good job getting rid of excessive low end. So at the final stage of the mix, I can do a boost like this. Now, this I think would be too much. So we would want to undo that, probably undo that, keep it more subtle, but it gives it just this little bit of a bump in the low end that makes you just feel a little better about that chorus. Now you could keep it boosted for the chorus, but I like the idea of it just kind of accenting that transition and then slowly fading out. And if you didn't know, you can actually have this fade out go with different curves. So it doesn't have to be a straight linear fade. You could have it fade out quicker or slower. Those are all adjustable inside the automation lane as well. All right, that's it for me. Thanks so much for watching. Big thanks to Gregor for giving me a hint of an idea that I brought to full completion here in this video and made it amazing. So I'll give me 80% credit. You can give Gregor 20%. You can tell him I said that. Just kidding. For those of you that think Gregor and I are mad at each other, this is a fun little game we play together. It's your turn, Greg. Why don't you do something? Just do something. All right. Thanks for watching. See you.